Good evening. This is the News at 6. I'm Ishan Russell. And of course, the News at 6 is the day's biggest developing stories that have been happening. And the two big developments, of course, today were President Pranab Mukherjee telling both the government and the opposition to sort it out in Parliament. What were the details? We'll be updating you on that over the next half hour. We'll also be talking about the Delhi elections, which, of course, are dominating the news. Another face in the Delhi politics for the BJP, this time a defection from the Congress. Who's that? We'll tell you in the next half hour. First, the headlines we're tracking today. President cautions government and opposition, says both ordinances and disruptions have a limited role in parliamentary democracy. BJP meets to finalise candidates for the Delhi elections and amid rumblings of dissent against new entrants. Jolt to the Congress as former union minister in the UPA, Krishna Tira, joins the BJP. And in the run-up to the budget, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley underscores the need to rationalise subsidies to ensure stability in policies to attract investment. Well, a top story. President Pranab Mukherjee slammed the slew of ordinances brought by the NDA government. He said the ordinance route cannot and should not be taken for normal legislation. The president's views assume significance in the context of the Modi government promulgating 9 ordinances, including the opening of the insurance sector to higher foreign investment after Parliament was paralysed in the winter session. He also criticised frequent disruptions in Parliament, asking the ruling party and the opposition to put their heads together and find out a workable solution. Alright, moving on to Delhi politics, where the Central Election Committee of the BJP will meet this evening to finalise its list of candidates for the Delhi Assembly polls. Now, the party is also expected to pick the face of the party for the elections. While the reports suggest that the newly joined Kiran Bedi could be the party's lead campaigner, there are rumblings within the party against her.
Former Delhi top cop Kiran Bedi addressed her first rally for BJP on Monday, kicking off her campaign for the state assembly polls. She is touted to be the face of BJP when the party meets to finalise its candidate for the elections. But according to reports, a section of the party is already opposing any such move. However, BJP denied any internal tussle over Kiran Bedi.
Kiran Bedi ji, Mukhyamantri pad ki उम्मीदवार नहीं घोषित की गई हैं, वो भारतीय जनता पार्टी में आई हैं और उनका भारतीय जनता पार्टी में स्वागत है। सीएम की घोषणा होनी बाकी है।
जो उनकी अपनी एक इमेज है, उसका पब्लिक में अच्छा असर है और आपने देखा होगा उनके आने के बाद कई सर्वेज ने उनको बाकी सबसे आगे निकलते हुए भी बतलाया है। भारतीय जनता पार्टी में उनका बहुत पुरजोर स्वागत भी किया गया है।
जो लोग ये अफवाह उड़ा रहे हैं कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी में कोई मतभेद है किरण बेदी जी को लेके, वो पूरी तरह गलत है। किरण बेदी जी के आने से भारतीय जनता पार्टी के सारे नेता और कार्यकर्ता और दिल्ली की जनता सब खुश है।
किरण बेदी सेड शी इज रेडी टू कंटेस्ट अगेंस्ट आम आदमी पार्टी कन्वीनर अरविंद केजरीवाल फ्रॉम न्यू दिल्ली सीट। She also features prominently on BJP posters outside the party headquarters, indicating that she would be one of the key BJP candidates in the race. But the party is facing questions why it has failed to project someone from its existing leadership in Delhi to lead the party into the elections. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And our correspondent Shyam Sundar is at the BJP headquarters where that crucial meeting for the Delhi politics of the BJP is to take place to decide the candidates. And Shyam, it will be a complicated situation for the BJP because, I mean, you have a whole host of new entrants into the party and you have a lot of people who have worked very actively with the party in Delhi as well. You had a whole host of leaders. So how does this entire thing work? Who's going to be given a ticket? Could we see any big names dropped from the election race this time?
Well, Ishan, as far as Delhi BJP is concerned and BJP's strategy for Delhi is concerned, it is very, very clear. On the very day when Kiran Bedi joined the party, it was very clear that she is going to get an important role in Delhi BJP and these elections. And on Sunday, all seven MPs of BJP were told to report to Mrs. Bedi and brief her about the works they have done in their respective constituencies. There was no doubt remained that she is going to be the face of the BJP in Delhi BJP. And today from Rohini, she has started her road show before formally she is declared the face of the party. So it is very clear that Kiran Bedi is going to be the face of the BJP in these elections. As far as senior BJP leaders are concerned in Delhi, yes, there are heartburns and there are leaders who are upset with the developments, and they are saying that they are working for BJP for very long, but the way BJP high command has dealt with the issue and the way these leaders are cautioned after that, they have changed their statements, whether it is Jagdish Mukhi or Mr. Manoj Tiwari. So it is very, very clear that the leadership of BJP, central leadership of BJP, has decided that Kiran Bedi will be the face of the party in BJP in Delhi elections for BJP, and she will be heading the campaign in Delhi. So it is very, very clear. Yes, there are few upset leaders, but they have no other option but to support Mrs. Bedi.
All right, Shyam, we leave it over there. Thanks very much for coming in and sharing our details of what's been happening at the BJP headquarters. Of course, Shyam will be keeping a track of that crucial meeting for us. All right, and staying with politics from Delhi, it was the turn of the Congress to deal with a high-profile defection from the party ranks. Former union minister in the UPA government, Krishna Tirath, joined the BJP. Just hours before the party is expected to release its list of candidates for the Delhi elections scheduled on 7th February.
A surprise induction for the BJP and a rude jolt for the Congress. Former UPA minister Krishna Tirath met BJP chief Amit Shah on Monday as a prelude to her joining the party.
देखिए मन परिवर्तन नहीं मैंने कहा डिसिप्लिन जब खराब हुआ उस डिसिप्लिन को खराबी के कारण मुझे लगा कि जहां डिसिप्लिन है जहां अच्छी सोच है जहां जनता को आगे बढ़ने के लिए आज जनता के साथ काम करने का मुझे मौका मिलेगा इसलिए
ऑल द बीजेपी लीडर्स वेलकम तीरथ इनटू द पार्टी फोल्ड दे देमसेल्फ्स सीम टेकन अबैक बाय द डेवलपमेंट
जिस क्षेत्र में आप रहती हैं उस क्षेत्र में और उस वर्ग में और उन लोगों में निश्चित रूप से ये ताकत मजबूत होगी हम भारतीय जनता पार्टी परिवार में श्रीमती कृष्णा तीरथ जी का जो वरिष्ठ नेता है हार्दिक स्वागत करते हैं
अगर कृष्णा तीरथ जी पार्टी में शामिल है हो रही हैं तो स्वागत है कांग्रेस और आम आदमी पार्टी में आकर्षण नहीं है दम नहीं है लीडरशिप नहीं इसलिए आ रहे हैं
कृष्णा तीरथ जी अपने आप में बहुत ही एक सक्षम बहुत ही समझदार बहुत ही सीनियर एक वरिष्ठ कार्यकर्ता भी मंत्री भी रही हैं और उनके आने से और उनके तजुर्बे से बहुत ही फायदा मिलेगा मुझे लगता है और जितने अच्छे लोग आए एक जगह पे आए वो तो अच्छी बात
तीरथ हैज बीन वन ऑफ द मोस्ट प्रोमिनेंट फेसेस ऑफ द कांग्रेस इन द नेशनल कैपिटल हर डिसीजन कम्स एज अ शॉक टू द पार्टी लीडर्स हु इंसिस्टेड दैट शी लेफ्ट आफ्टर बीइंग डिनाइड टिकट फॉर द स्टेट इलेक्शंस तीरथ कंटेस्टेड द नेशनल इलेक्शंस फ्रॉम दिल्ली लास्ट ईयर एंड लॉस्ट टू बीजेपीज उदित राज
जितना लोग lost their deposit in the last election, we could not provide them a seat. There is no other reason.
Tirath is the latest in a series of public faces to join the BJP in the run-up to the Delhi elections. Last week, some well-known names associated with the Aam Aadmi Party movement, Kiran Bedi, Shazia Ilmi and Vinod Kumar Binni joined the BJP.
Binni bhai humare ko bahut samay pehle, ek saal pehle chhod ke chale gaye the. Shazia ji 6 mahine pehle chhod ke gayi thi. Kiran ji to kabhi humare saath thi hi nahi. अब उसको अचानक पलायन की तरह पेश किया जा रहा है मैं तो समझता नहीं कैसे होता है एक ही खबर को बार बार कैसे पेश किया जाता है
तीरथ हैज बीन अ कांग्रेस लेजिस्लेटर एंड एमपी फ्रॉम दिल्ली शी सर्वड एज यूनियन मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट विद इंडिपेंडेंट चार्ज फॉर वुमेन एंड चाइल्ड डेवलपमेंट इन द मनमोहन सिंह गवर्नमेंट ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट राज्यसभा टीवी
And not to be left out, the Congress party is also raising the political pitch in Delhi, releasing a booklet today that highlighted the U-turns taken by the Aam Aadmi Party chief Arvind Kejriwal during his 49-day tenure as Delhi chief minister. The booklet cites 16 promises which were left unfulfilled by the former Delhi chief minister. Congress also filed a complaint against Kejriwal to the Election Commission today for his comments at a rally on Sunday. Kejriwal had stirred a controversy by asking voters to take money from both the Congress and the BJP, but to vote for the Aam Aadmi Party in the Delhi Assembly elections.
कि अरविंद केजरीवाल जी जिस वक्त ये कहते हैं कि दिल्ली की जनता को कि वो कांग्रेस और भारतीय जनता पार्टी दोनों से पैसे ले लें, तो वो एक ना केवल बहुत गैर जिम्मेदाराना बयान है, वो ना केवल दिल्ली के लोगों का अपमान है बल्कि साथ साथ असंवैधानिक भी है। लिहाजा मैं आपको बताना चाहता हूं कि हमारे लीगल डिपार्टमेंट ने इलेक्शन कमीशन को एक कंप्लेंट करा है।
The correspondent Vishal Daya has been tracking all the developments happening at the Congress office and also disappointment for the Congress today. Vishal, what prompted Krishna Thira to suddenly quit from the Congress and join the BJP? I mean, she was a high-profile Congress leader from Delhi.
Well, yes, you're right. As far as what prompted Krishna Thirath, Ishan, then that is something which has been answered by Krishna Thirath, saying that, just like Kiran Bedi, it was the inner voice which urged Krishna Thirath to go ahead and switch sides just before the elections. But yes, as far as Congress is concerned, this is, a sort of a blow, though they are trying to underplay this movement of leaders from Congress to the BJP, saying that, during the last Lok Sabha elections, she could not gather enough votes. But then let's not forget that Krishna Thirath was one of those leaders from the state of Delhi who became a union minister. She held a very important portfolio, that's women and child development, and she was the member of parliament for 10 years. So obviously she might have lost the elections once, but then definitely as far as Congress goes, this is something which is going to be detrimental for the Congress's entire game plan of reviving its electoral fortunes in the city state out here.
Absolutely, because the fortunes were really dependent on a certain vote, the backward caste vote, which the Aam Aadmi Party had very smartly managed to capitalize on during the last assembly elections. So does this give BJP a shot in the arm, given the fact that Krishna Thirath is viewed in many circles in Delhi politics as a backward caste leader? You have the presence of other leaders of the BJP like Udit Raj over there on the stage when she was being welcomed into the party. So that becomes a focus area, and that vote bank certainly seems to be the target for all three, the Aam Aadmi Party and the BJP and the Congress.
Well, yes, it is indeed. This entire fight is about the vote bank, because if you look at the backward caste votes, which might end up influencing which way the wheel of fortune will turn as far as these parties are concerned, then definitely leaders like Krishna Thirath, Udit Raj, and till now Congress did have a Dalit face in Krishna Thirath, but then with she also moving towards BJP, now Congress will have to try and shore up its strategy, because if you look at another important player in this vote segment, that's BSP, the Bahujan Samajwadi Party. They've also announced their intentions to go ahead and fight the elections on all 70 seats. It's not that they're doing it for the first time, but then it seems that this time around Mayawati seems to be pretty serious about the Delhi Assembly elections, and that should not sound sort of a good news for both the Congress and Aam Aadmi Party.
All right, we leave it over there, Vishal Daya. Thanks very much for that analysis for us. All right, and staying with Delhi, Aam Aadmi Party leader Manish Sisodia filed his nomination papers from the Patparganj constituency today. Sisodia will be seeking to get re-elected from the seat he currently represents. In the 2013 assembly poll, Sisodia had contested from Patparganj for the first time. He remains confident that the AAP will come out victorious in the Delhi polls against a tough challenge by both the BJP and the Congress. According to reports, AAP convener Arvind Kejriwal is scheduled to file his nomination papers on Tuesday.
इस बार ये नॉमिनेशन सिर्फ पटपड़गंज के लिए नहीं, मैंने दिल्ली में पूर्ण बहुमत के लिए दुआ मांगी है भगवान से। इस बार दिल्ली की जनता पूर्ण बहुमत से आम आदमी पार्टी की सरकार लेके आएगी, उसमें पटपड़गंज सीट भी शामिल होगी।
Right, we'll take a very quick break right now, but coming up on the other side, security has been massively stepped up for US President Barack Obama's visit. What will be happening? We'll be telling you on the other side. Welcome back. This is the News at 6. Right, ahead of the general budget next month, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley today said there was a need to rationalize old subsidies and increase public spending on infrastructure in the coming months. Now, the government subsidy bill towards oil and fertilizers runs into lakhs of crore rupees. Jaitley also underlined the need for stability in tax and other policies to make India an attractive investment destination.
The center has hinted that it will rationalize all subsidies soon. The government is expected to incorporate the suggestions of the Expenditure Finance Commission, headed by former RBI Governor Bimal Jalan, in the budget proposals for the next financial year. Jalan is reported to have submitted interim recommendations to the Finance Ministry, suggesting various steps to rationalize subsidies and public expenditure.
From 1st January onwards, the LPG subsidy goes into the bank accounts. The Expenditure Management Commission has made some interim suggestions. I am looking at them. And then you will have to gradually address the rationalization of all possible subsidies.
He also said that the government will increase public spending on infrastructure in months to come. The government estimates the country needs to spend close to 5,000 crore rupees on infrastructure to grow 7% per annum, sharply higher than around 5.5% projected by the RBI for the current fiscal year. Jaitley said that the public spending on infrastructure would have to increase because the old PPP model was under stress and needed to be revived.
Where in months to come our emphasis is going to be on far greater investment, both domestic and international. We have to concentrate on manufacturing. We have to concentrate on infrastructure.
Jaitley also underlined the need for stability in tax and other policies to make India an attractive place for investment.
I've been struggling in the last few months to rationalize our taxation to make it as far as non-adversarial. Our effort is going to be to make sure that as far as our tax structures, our budgetary processes are concerned, they are perfectly transparent. I do not favor the idea of there being any concealed fiscal deficit.
Jaitley had promised eminent changes, pushing ahead with key reforms such as the introduction of a nationwide sales tax. He said the implementation of the goods and services tax will help in improving the business climate in the country. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, American President Barack Obama's visit to India for the Republic Day celebrations has set in motion unprecedented security preparations. The Border Security Force has stepped up security along the international border in Jammu and Kashmir to check infiltration attempts. Strong security arrangements are also being put in place in Delhi to host Obama. A 7-layer security ring will be thrown around the VVIP enclosure at Rajpath for the parade to be witnessed by the American president.
Amid reports that terrorists could strike during US President Barack Obama's visit to India, the center has stepped up security ahead of his 3-day tour. BSF has deployed close to 1,200 personnel along the Indo-Pak border to check infiltration attempts. Recently, the army said that hundreds of militants are waiting to infiltrate through J&K border at a time when Obama visits for the Republic Day celebrations. Tight security measures have also been taken in Delhi, where Obama will be the chief guest for the parade.
The head of the state's visit has to be taken care of. It is a sovereign responsibility. It's not a question of one president of a country. It is the incumbent upon the security agencies, the state, the whole state, as a nation. It is our responsibility. There's nothing we can, speak something specially related to one particular visit.
Pakistan has been trying to escalate trouble on the international border and LOC with India. India has been repeatedly warning Pakistan of its export of terror. India government is fully prepared to meet any challenge.
A 7-tier security cordon will be in place to protect Obama during the Republic Day celebrations. Snipers will be positioned and the airspace over the area will be monitored by specially set up radars. Face recognition cameras are being installed at Delhi's entry points and CCTV cameras will monitor the routes taken by the US President. Metro stations and offices around the Rajpath area will be taken over 72 hours in advance at the request of US security personnel. India has reportedly rejected the US demand for a no-fly zone over Rajpath as it would mean no-fly past one of the main draws of the Republic Day ceremony. President Obama is expected to follow protocol and forego his own bulletproof car known as the Beast to ride to the venue with President Pranab Mukherjee. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And Sri Lankan Foreign Minister Mangala Samaravira, who is on a 3-day visit to India, met Prime Minister Narendra Modi today. Samaravira's talks with the Prime Minister at his residence were focused on strengthening bilateral relations. Delegates from both sides were present during the meeting. Samaravira met his counterpart Sushma Swaraj on Sunday. Ahead of the visit, India and Sri Lanka agreed to re-engage on repatriation of refugees from India. Sri Lanka released 15 Indian fishermen who were in its custody. Now, after days of speculation, the Delhi Police Commissioner B.S. Bassi clarified that Congress MP Shashi Tharoor has not been questioned yet in connection with his wife Sunanda Pushkar's murder. But he said that Tharoor is likely to be questioned in a day or two. He said they've not ruled out anything and all angles are being probed. He maintained that all people relevant to the case are being examined by the SIT. Some of those questioned in the case so far include Tharoor's domestic help Narayan Singh, Tharoor's family friend Sanjay Diwan, the hotel doctor who pronounced Sunanda dead, and the hotel staff, including its manager. Police say that the process to send Sunanda's viscera samples to a lab abroad is on.
तो क्या सर शशि थरूर से पूछताछ हो गई है या होनी है?
नहीं, मेरे ख्याल में अभी मतलब अभी नहीं हुई है, पर जल्दी ही होगी. आज वो बाहर हैं, शायद शाम को वापस आएंगे. शाम 7-1-7 बजे तक वापस आएंगे, तो हो सकता है कल या परसों में फिर उनसे बातचीत की जाएगी.
Now, fog and cold wave conditions continue to prevail in most parts of North India. Delhi experienced yet another foggy morning today with minimum temperatures settling at 6.4 degrees Celsius. Visibility at the airport was reported to be nil at 6 a.m. About 33 flights were affected due to harsh weather conditions, of which 21 were delayed. According to reports, 169 trains were running late due to dense fog. Meanwhile, the minimum temperatures in most places in Kashmir, including Ladakh region, rose by around 1 degree. The Met Office has predicted rains or snow in the next few days that could drive temperatures lower. Well, time now to look at some of the other stories from across the country and nationwide. 14 people were arrested in Bihar's Muzaffarpur district for allegedly burning down a dozen houses on Sunday. At least 3 people were killed. A high-level probe has been ordered. Bihar Chief Minister Jitin Ram Manji, who was on a pilgrimage tour to Mumbai, cancelled his tour to be in Patna. Hundreds of policemen are posted in Muzaffarpur to avoid further clashes. Public sector bank employees will go on a 4-day strike on Wednesday over the long pending wage revision issue. The decision is in response to the strike call given by the United Forums of Bank Unions, which has more than 10 lakh employees and officers of banking industry under its umbrella. An encounter between security personnel and Maoists killed a rebel and injured one policeman on Sunday. A joint team of the CRPF and police acted upon receiving a tip-off. The injured police officer has been admitted to a hospital. The police also arrested 2 Maoists and recovered weapons. Eminent cartoonist R.K. Lakshman has been admitted to hospital in Pune after his health deteriorated suddenly on Sunday evening. Lakshman was suffering from a urinary infection and reportedly had a multi-organ failure. He's said to be on ventilator support and is in an unconscious state. Some international news now, and the Islamabad High Court today extended the detention of 2008 Mumbai terror attack accused Zakir Rehman Lakhmi by 1 month. The court gave the order after hearing the petition moved by Federal Investigation Agency pleading to cancel the Lakhmi's bail. Lakhmi was put under detention under the maintenance of public order after an anti-terrorism court granted him bail in December last year. However, this detention order was suspended by court. Lakhmi was arrested again in a kidnapping case later. The next hearing of the case will take place on the 26th of January. Diplomats confirmed a limited progress in the nuclear talks in Geneva between Iran and world powers. Both sides are slated to meet again next month. Iran and the P5+1 group of nations, including Britain, China, France, Russia, and the United States and Germany, met for talks to limit Tehran's nuclear program in exchange for easing international sanctions. All sides agreed to step up efforts to reach a political understanding by the end of March while working towards a full-blown deal by the self-imposed deadline of 30th June. This is the second meeting between the two nations after the failure to meet on a 24th November deadline last year. Well, time for a quick break right now, but coming up on the other side, all the latest news from the Australian Open. Yuki Bambrian's gone down to Andy Murray, sadly, though, for Indian hopes. Welcome back. You're watching the News at 6. Let's get you updated on sports now. Australian opener David Warner has been fined 50% of his match fee after his on-field spat with Indian opener Rohit Sharma. Warner got into a verbal duel with Rohit Sharma on Sunday during the second one-day international in Melbourne. The incident occurred at the end of the 23rd over of India's innings when India took an overthrow and the Australians were showed their displeasure, thinking the ball had ricocheted off Rohit Sharma's legs. The two players then got into an animated verbal duel, prompting the umpire to step in. Warner later defended his use of words but admitted his mistake into getting a verbal squabble with Rohit Sharma. Whoever was throwing the ball, I guess the unwritten rule. And tennis now, where big guns Rafael Nadal and Andy Murray successfully blasted their way into the Australian Open second round. But the dream of Anna Ivanovic was shattered. Ivanovic was among the biggest seeded players in the women's category to crash out on the opening day. She was defeated by world number 142, Lucy Radeka of Czech Republic in three sets. World number 3 Nadal has no such problems and was in full control against Russian Mikhail Yuzhny. But there was heartbreak for India as Yuki Bambri lost to Andy Murray in the opening round. However, he gave Murray a testing workout before losing 6-3, 6-4, 7-6. Well, that's it from us. News and updates continue on Rajya Sabha TV, so keep watching.